The sights and sounds of construction. A new home being built from the ground up so someone can move in.
First, they didn't know where I was.
That someone is this man, Sergeant Joey Smith. He suffered spinal cord and brain injuries while deployed in Afghanistan in 2004. To him, this home in Randolph County means one thing.
To me, it means independence. I'd be able to depend on myself instead of, you know, people, you know, it just means a lot to me.
Smith spent almost 4 years in a hospital undergoing speech and physical therapy to recover from his near-fatal injuries. And this house will be specifically built so he can get around in his wheelchair and spend time with his wife and children.
I'm tremendously grateful that the community would come together as a whole. You know, people from all walks of life.
Some of the folks who came together are veterans. Their goal? Finish the house by Sunday night. Sergeant Serge Ziegler is an active member of the Army. He brought 10 people from his platoon.
It just seems like a lot of people forget about them and don't realize that the wounded soldiers coming back also need some help. The military doesn't back them as much as they should now that they're out of the military. So this is my way of trying to say, hey, the Army cares about you. I care about you. I want to help you.
Homes for Our Troops is the organization in charge of building this home and ones like it, which allow disabled veterans around the country to get homes that fit their needs. Sergeant Smith says he can't wait to move into his new home, and he has goals of his own he wants to achieve.
Right now, my goal is to make the 2012 Paralympic team for archery. Just training every day.
Smith will chase that Olympic dream, knowing his dream of owning a special home is about to become reality. Craig Thomas, WXII 12.